Today we're going to talk about the Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Hey there, NJRoute22.com here with the bubbly background and our Vizzy graphics on the side. And we're going to talk about the Vizzy Hard Seltzer, which have various flavors. I'm going to list the flavors up here in the background. I don't have the box with me. I forgot what I did with it. But anyway, I picked up this interesting seltzer the other day because it hit all the low-carb marks for the most part. And they had these, their little twist here is they have little antioxidants and vitamins in them. Like, this is going to boost my strength. It's ridiculous that I even believe that. It's probably of no real effect to you, but that's... I mean, this is on paper, you know, this is it meets the marks for us. And they probably are doing well here because they are hitting a niche that hadn't been really tapped into in these seltzer markets. You need to be different to stand out these days. But these have 5% alcohol. It's 2 grams of carbs per can, which is double. My favorite is 1 gram. And they have 1 gram of sugar in them, and that's not good. They're produced by the Molson Coors Corporation. They're the largest domestic beer company in America. Bud is like 5 times their size, but they're a global corporation. And I have a feeling when it comes to these massive corporations that it's more about profits than it is producing the best product. They don't really care. They're just gonna figure out a formula. The formula is you, the customer, and the cheapest way to make something and to tap into some sort of psychological hook that gets you to buy their product. And the fact that this has any added sugar at all bothers us, because and they also have natural flavors, which I'm suspicious of across the board. I don't know why the stupid government allows them to put natural flavors. They can include anything, including MSG, and not tell you what is in those natural flavors. That bothers me. They have to, that's not transparent, and they have to fix that. There's an interesting trend here in the market, because this low-carb market is blowing up. There's like hundreds of different low-carb seltzers now. And these big corporations, they didn't get into the market as quick as the smaller guys, I guess, for whatever reasons, legal reasons. But my suspicion is that they have these mad scientists in a lab somewhere, totally working day and night to figure out, A, the cheapest way to make it, and to make it more addictive, I believe. Something about it, the marketing and everything else, just, it seems like this, they had a focus group of scientists trying to figure out what were the best check marks to hit in order to make a profitable product for this large billion-dollar corporation. But forget about our theories. You probably want to know how did I like. If you only care about the buzz and you don't care about who made it and what the nefarious actions are behind the scenes, I suppose there's some psychosomatic effects of saying, oh, there's antioxidants in there that make you feel better while you're drinking it. And I don't think they were bad in any way at all. And I think I did drink a little more than I normally do with the Smirnoffs, which have zero sugar. And they don't smash your sugar levels, but I'm getting a new theory here that even a drop of sugar in your drink just makes you drink 1 or 2 or 3 more. I just think there's some sort of addictive nature, even at low levels of sugar. The whole theory is that, you know, sugar at low levels doesn't, you know, take you out of ketosis, for instance. But I think sugar at any amount creates an appetite or just makes you want more. We're going to put our theories to the test again and try maybe 1 or 2 more times. But I just think those giant corporations have a lot of money to play with, and I think they're doing some crazy stuff in those top secret labs over there. What do you think? Have you tried it? What's your favorite seltzer? If you like this video, please hit the bell and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.